Hello, this is Jose Luis, and welcome to this new exercise video in the series Introduction to Parametric Modeling, where I'm going to extend on what we did in the previous video with the drinking glass, and it's going to be a very, very similar example. Technically, it's just going to be a little more complicated because it's going to be designing the shape of a flower vase. And this is just going to involve working a little bit more with the curvature of the surface, but the techniques of relating points to each other is going to be the exact same thing pretty much. So I'm going to have all still the option of moving this in any point at any point in X, Y in the world coordinate system. And then I'm going to be able to play with the radius of the vase and with the radius of other parts of the vase, and then play with the curvature and how this looks in 3D space. It's going to be super interesting and it's going to allow me to create formal families of different parametric vases. So if you're interested in this, give it a try and check out this video. Otherwise, it's going to be very similar to the one to the drinking glass. So you may want to just skip to the next video, perhaps, if you think you know what we're doing. Okay. All right, let's get hands on. So if you remember, in our previous exercise, we did a drinking glass, which was very simply a center point and then two other points that we wanted to control for the curvature, if you will, of that glass. So if we're going to make a flower vase, this exercise is going to be technically identical to the previous one. I just think it's very important, so that's why I want to reinforce the idea. But if you thought you had the last one under control, maybe you want to skip over this one, I don't know. But the idea is going to be very, very simple. What I want to do is I want to create some kind of flower vase that looks something like this. So I start with an opening, and then maybe it has some kind of smoother curvature like this, and it ends up also on some kind of shape here, on some kind of base here. And maybe this one is just going to be a little more complex, it's going to be a little more complicated, not more complex, which means that basically what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be creating also a profile that is going to be a straight line in the base, but then the other profile, instead of being another straight line, is now going to be a spline, it's going to be a curve. And then very likely what I would like to do now here is control what the center of the point is. I would like to control the radius of the base, and then I would like to control the position of other points that are going to give me the shape of the curvature. So maybe there is a point here, maybe there is another point here, and maybe there is another point here. So by working with those three points, I can control the curvature of the profile of the vase, and I can play with its how wide it is, how tall it is, etc., etc. So how are we going to do this then? Well, parameters are going to be just like we did before. We're going to have a point, which is going to be the center. Okay, I'm going to call this point number 0. Then I'm going to have another point that is going to be point number 1, which is going to be at a distance r. So that's going to be the radius. And then I'm going to have three other points, which I'm going to call point number 2, point number 3, and then point number 4. And then what I'm going to do now is, just like I did in the previous exercise, instead of controlling them, each one of them individually in relation to the center, what I would like to do is control them sequentially, so that whatever I do to this point, for example, affects what happens to the following points, to point 3 and point 4. Because I think, in my opinion, and again, this is my opinion, you may have a different opinion, in my opinion, that kind of relationship is much nicer for modeling, because it allows you to fine tweak and to adjust things from the global to the local scale. That's kind of how I like doing things. So that's why what I'm going to do is I'm going to define three heights. So I'm going to define the height of point number 2, I'm going to define the height of point number 3, which is going to be not the total height, but how far away from point number 2 that point is going to be. And I'm going to define another height, which is going to be height number 4. And then for each one of them, I'm going to define as well, I'm going to define B2, which is going to be how far off point 2 is in relation to the previous one. Then I'm going to define B3, which is how far off point 3 is from point number 2. And also B4, which is how far off point number 4 is going to be from point number 3. Then I'm going to create a interpolated curve, and then I will revolve that over an axis and then generate that form. Okay, so conceptually it's going to be almost identical to what we did before. It's just going to be a little more tedious, it's going to have more steps, but it's going to be conceptually the same thing. So shall we give it a try? Let's give it a try. We are back in Rhino and Grasshopper, and for this exercise, because it's going to be very similar to the previous one, I'm actually going to do a little fast. So if you can't keep it up, just slow down the video, or otherwise just look at what I'm doing, because I think you're going to be able to reproduce this very simply. So I created a point here, and now I double click and I bring in an empty point parameter that I use to import that point into Grasshopper. And then I'm just going to drop here some bifocals so that those of you who don't use icons can also follow up with the video. Then I'm going to decompose, well, I'm going to set up my parameters. That's going to be a slider that is going to be the radius. And I'm actually going to do this offline and then I'll be back. So I'm going to create the parameters that I have defined in my diagram. So here we are. So we have the point, we have the radius of the base, and then we have the increment of each one of the points, B1, B2, and B3, and we have the heights of each one of the points, height 1, height 2, and height 3. I think I actually did the numbers wrong. I think here I said B2, B3, B4, and H2 there. So you're going to forgive me about that inconsistency, but yes. So now we have this, and then remember, the first thing we're going to do is the first point is going to be the first point is going to be where point 0 was, and then we're going to add the x to the x coordinate, we're going to add the radius. So we're going to do that, and we're going to say I'm going to deconstruct this point, I'm going to take its coordinates, and then to this coordinates I'm going to add the radius to the x coordinate. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to construct a new point. So that's going to be this one, and this one. And for the radius, I'm going to open it up a little bit like this. Okie dokie. So that's going to be, and I like, please label everything. Okay, so that's going to be point 1. And then point 2 is going to be, again, I'm going to deconstruct the previous point. I do have the numbers here. I could plug it right away, but it's a little easier to read, I think, if we do it this way. So I'm going to deconstruct this, and I'm going to say, well, for as per the diagram, to x, I need to increase by b, and z needs to be increased by the height. So I'm going to say, okay, so I'm going to add to the x, I'm going to add b1, and then I'm going to double click addition, and then to the z, I'm going to add the height. And then I'm going to construct a point with this coordinate, and this coordinate. Okie dokie. So that's going to be point number 2. All right. And then that's going to be that. I'm going to open up a little bit like here. And then I'm going to copy and paste the whole thing, which it's very dangerous, okay? So I highly recommend you never do this because copy-pasting is the devil. It always gives errors, or like it makes debugging things very difficult. So I'm just going to replug this one here. So I'm deconstructing the previous one now. And now I'm adding the new base to the x and the new height to here. And then I have the third point. The third point is going to be, I want to bring it negative a little bit. And the height is going to be short here. And then I'm going to do the same operation. I'm going to copy and paste all of this. And then this is going to be point number 4. And then the point that I want to deconstruct now is this one. And the base that I need to add is B3. And the height that I need to add is H4. Okay. And then I have my fourth point here. So I have my fourth point, and that point is going to be there. And then you can see that it looks like I have the profile kind of, but the radius is a little too much. Well, we can see that very soon. Okay, so what am I going to do? First of all, because In this case, my modeling is that I have here, I have a straight line, and here I have an interpolated curve. In this case, I cannot do the both things at once because they're different kinds of geometry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first create a simple line between point zero and point one. So that's going to be, between point zero and point one. So that's going to be the line for the base. And then for the other points, I'm just going to join them with an interpolated curve. So I'm going to do to here, to curve, spline, interpolate, and I'm going to add the first point, then I'm going to shift press to add the second point, press shift to add the third point, and press shift to add the fourth point. All right. And then you can see that now I have the profile, which is an interpolated curve. Awesome. So now the only thing that I need to do is I need to do the revolution, just like I had before. So I click here, I place a revolution. The profile is going to be this one. The axis, remember that we need to generate. So I'm going to also, I'm going to deconstruct the point here. I'm going to add to the X to the Z coordinate. No, sorry, not this point, the one at the base here. So the one at the base, I'm going to deconstruct it. I'm going to add some number, for example, the value of one. And this one doesn't need to be a parameter because it's just auxiliary geometry. I'm going to construct the point again with the same X, the same Y, and the Z that is a little higher. I'm going to create a point, a line between those two. So that's going to be the base point and the new point that I just created. So this is going to be the axis of revolution. And then I'm going to plug this in here as the axis. All right. Wonderful. So it looks like it's working, right? So let me do a couple ticks. So I'm just going to, let me find a nicer base. So for example, the radius, and then I'm just going to decrease this height a little bit. And then what am I going to do? Oh, look at this. How cool is this? Yoo-hoo. Look how by affecting one, everything that comes after gets affected, and how by affecting the one in the bottom, everything also. Oh, this is pretty neat, right? I like this. Oh, sorry, my head is on the way. But I think we could be cool with this, except for one tiny detail. So if you look at the situation closely, if I bake this now and I take a closer look, what we can see is that actually the vase is empty in the bottom. There is no base. And depending on what we're doing for rendering, this may actually not be a good thing. That is because, and I'm going to delete this, the only thing that we have revolved is actually the interpolated curve here on the side, which was this component here. We have not revolved the line. Okay? So there's two things we can do. We could just copy paste the revolution component, and instead of revolving this curve, we could just revolve this line. And then here we would end up with a surface that is the base, you see, that base, and then another surface that is the profile. However, this is not very, very clean, because basically we have two different surfaces, and if we want to move things around, etc., it's just not great. So what we can do actually is we can join the two curves, the straight line segment and the interpolated curve, into one single curve that has these two segments. The way we can do that is by joining curves. So actually, I forget where that is here in utilities. If you click here, you can see that you have join curves. So I can place this component and then I can join the line with the interpolated curve. What that gives me is a planar curve that I can now plug into the revolution. And you can see how this turned darker. That's because now this is also a surface. And if I bake my vase, you can see that the whole thing is now has a top and that is open and a bottom that is closed. All right. Okay, so this is going to be the surface. And then should we have some fun? and create some. All right, so let me go here and now create what? I'm going to create one that is a bit more slender, perhaps. So I'm going to switch. Oh, look what's happening here. I'm having this like kind of flute effect. I'm going to make like this really elegant thingy. So it's going to be this, and then this is going to be super slim, and it's going to be here, and the opening of the other one is going to be super thin. So I like that. It's kind of like very like, so I'm going to bake this, and maybe I can do a third one that is a bit more like shorter and more open wide. So I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to reduce the height here. Maybe this is a little too much. Maybe I want something like this. That's kind of cool, actually. I'm going to keep that one. And yes. And then I'm just going to move this all the way out here. Alrighty. So this was the generation of an algorithm. Remember, we are designing parametric algorithms. This was the generation of an algorithm to create parametric vases for flowers, for example. And with that, we have created the tree of relationship, which is starting to look like a spaghetti of trees, but nonetheless, it works. And it allows us to explore formally the generation of these vases, okay, which I think is kind of nice. So this was an exercise to try parametric flower vases. I hope you liked that. If you did, maybe you want to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And otherwise, you may continue to the next video in this series, Introduction to Parametric Modeling, where I think I'm going to keep doing more exercises. We're going to try a different thing on the next video. So stay tuned and see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Thank you.